Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we're gonna talk about this belt buckle ring it's been using in the fashion jewelry a lot. Let's take a look on how to make it. Are you ready? Let's get started. So we're gonna starting making a ring size. I'm going to set it radius for 8. And then we need to know how long it is if it is straightening flat. So let's use the command called length, and it says 50.265. So I'm gonna make a straight line and type it 50.265. And then this is mean if this line, this circle is being straightened and how long it's going to be. So that's gonna be our guideline. And we are going to make a ring shank first. For our ring shank, it's going to be the same length. And I wanted to type 50.265. And then it's gonna be the width for 3.5. And the thickness, I think this is not a too thick of a ring, so either 1 or 1.2 will work. So I'm just gonna type it 1 there. So this is the ring shank that we are going to have. We're gonna do the fillet later, but let's go ahead to do the buckle part. On the buckle part, I'm just gonna do it right here. Let's take a look on the top view. I'm going to draw the shape of my buckle. I like to use this conic corners. So let's right click on it and use the center, and I can snap it into the midpoint. So you kind of draw something look like this. You can make it more rectangle if you want to. Okay, so now I have one there. I'm going to make a copy holding the shift and also use the gumbo and then tap the alt key there. So then you will make a copy out of it. All right, so I'm going to move this out so it's easier for you to see. If I'm going to change the shape and then I kind of change shape like that, you notice right here it is the kink. It's because now the curve is a degree 2. So we need to rebuild the curve to make it a degree 3, so that way we can alter it better. So that's I will stay the same with the 8 point and then coming over like that. So now let's do one more time. If I want to change the shape, you can see the form is flow much better. Okay, so that is one thing. The second thing is I may want to move this to the left a little bit. All right, so depends on, and we're gonna bring back here, see if everything fitted well. You wanna make sure after you making into the solid, a well intersect. So I'm going to draw a curve using the arc tool, and then it's gonna go from here to here and something like this. All right, so what that is going to do is to say from the top view, I want to have a shape like that, but from the side view, I need that little bit curve over there. And then we are going to use the command, it's called curve from two view. We're gonna pick up this curve and this curve, and also this curve and this curve. So that way it gives us two new curves. Let me hide the old one, so that curve is something like this, right? All we need to do now is creating the profile. So we're gonna do the conic corner. I'm gonna do with the 3 points, so quadrant, and I want something going up for whatever height that you like and going a little bit rounded. So we're gonna do one more time, 3 point, quadrant to quadrant, and going up like this. All right, so what is this is going to be our profile to sweep. So let's give it a try and see what's the shape look like. We're gonna do sweep to rail, rail one, rail two, cross and cross section, and make sure the direction and arrow is all in line, and we can close the sweep, and let's take a look on this. All right, so this is the element for the belt buckle that's moving in, and that's moving into the center. So the easiest way is align those to the center, and then you're gonna see something like this. And apparently we need to get it a little bit lower, right? anything lower than that is going to be chopped off. So just make sure that this is the angle you like. If it is need to be thicker or thinner or whatever, that's gonna look on the design, look good on the design. All right, so now we have this. The second thing that we wanted to do is that pin over there. This could be pretty easy. We're going to just draw a line somewhere, go from here and coming down to the middle. So this is where the pin is going to be. We are going to move that pin close to here so it's easier to see. We're just gonna go ahead and pipe it. We're going to pipe whatever aesthetic is fitting into your design, and it will look something like this. Okay, so let's do alignment one more time. Let's align horizontal to the center so everything look good over there. Okay, now we have this. We need to create the hole to make it look like it's coming out from the hole there. I won't suggest you actually punch a hole. We just need to have an impression of the hole. So I'm going to snap in into somewhere in the middle, and I'm going to draw a sphere just a little bit bigger than the pin. So something like this. And let's move that sphere to the top. Let's go ahead to give it a try. We're gonna use Boolean Difference, and this will be difference out of that ball. And then so let's take a look. It does look like it's coming out from something, but it doesn't go all the way. So that ball will work, right? So we're gonna do Control Z, and then we're gonna have this ball coming out the same distance. So copy, Control C, Control V for paste, and we want to move it out for 4 millimeter. Okay, do the same thing one more time, move that one out 4 millimeter too. And then you can do, you know, multiple, maybe one more if you like to. But what I'm going to do is we are going to use Boolean Difference. This will be difference out from here. Okay, when you look at the render, it might not look good with the harsh edge there. So what I would like to do is give a little bit fillet, and let's do something really small, maybe 0.1. It just look much better on the rendering, as you can see over here. So for the comparison, you can see this one is really nice and rounded, and this one is just like look too machine looking. Let's go ahead to fillet this edges and also this edges as well. Okay, so they are all nice and rounded. Okay, so now one more thing that we wanted to do is the belt buckle. It has a catch, usually has a catch over there. So I'm going to use the conic corner again, and we are going to draw something like this. And then we're gonna creating a profile. So let's go ahead to move this one close to here, and that's creating a profile. And again, I'm gonna use the conic corners, and this time we're gonna do from the top view. Okay, so now what we have is the sweep one rail. This is the rail, this is the cross section, and we're gonna get something like this. Okay, so this is going to slide it back to here. And now if it is like too fat, you can kind of scale it down. We don't actually need to make it function, but we need to make it look like it is function. However, try not to have any gap in between, because you might have a casting issue over there. Okay, so now we have this one maybe a little bit thinner. So as long as it has that look, that will be fine. Okay, so now we have everything ready. Before we do bowling and everything, we want to make sure that we want to fit it first. This is really important. In this case, you want to fit it first before you bowling unit together. All right, so let's go ahead to do the fillet. And let's try the radius for 0.35, and we want to fit it all these edges. Okay, so now it is fitted. Let's double make sure everything is aligned. So let's use the horizontal align to the center. Now we can Boolean unit together. Okay, once it's a Boolean unit, we are going to trim the bottom off. So I'm going to draw another box, cover the entire things, and going to the bottom. And we just need to do the Boolean difference. This will be difference out of that. All right, so now we have it flat and it's ready to flow it back to the ring. Let's go ahead to use the flow along curve. This object will be flow, and this is the base curve, and this is the target curve. Alright, so if it go inside, meaning the direction is not right, we're gonna do one more time. We're gonna pick up this object, enter. This time you want to pick up the base curve on this side and target curve on the same side. So that's how you get this bell buckle looking ring. This is today's bell buckle ring tutorial. I hope you enjoy. Please leave a comment below. Let me know how you're doing, and I will see you next.